Hi, in the previous part, we talked about an assignment which consists of 5 problems. And these 5 problems have been taken from 3 different topics of robotics engineering. These 3 topics are robot dynamics, trajectory planning, and robot control. So in the problem, it is stated that we need to use 2 cubics to define the trajectory. Okay. So we need 2 cubics. The first cubic is theta t is equal to a10 plus a11t plus a12t square plus a13t cube. And the second one is written like this. So using these 2 cubics, you can generate the trajectory. So let's see the procedure in the MATLAB. So in the MATLAB, first I have used 2 command clc and clr. This will make the command window clear. And if anything, any value is stored in the MATLAB, then those values will be deleted. Next, you can define these coefficients of the cubic by symbols. So there are 2 methods to define any parameter in the MATLAB. The first method is algebraic method, and the second method is numerical method. So you can assign a numerical value to this parameter a10 and all other parameter of the cubic, or you can save these parameters by their names itself, so using the command sims. So there are these parameters in the cubic, and the one parameter or variable is time t. So I have stored all the parameters of this cubic. So in the MATLAB, this expression can be written like this, and this expression can be written like this. You can take derivative of this expression using the command diff. Similarly, derivative of this expression can be done in this way. Similarly, we can take double derivative of any expression. For that, we need to take differentiation of this theta 1 dot. Okay, take a derivative of theta 1 dot, again you will get theta 1 d dot. Okay, now set the time. So initial time is 0, and the initial time is designated by the parameter t1 0. Okay, and the final time is t1 n, that is equal to 1.5. So for this cubic, initial time is 0 and the final time is 1.5. You can change these initial and final values as per your choice. So any value can be assigned. Next, for this expression, the initial value is taken 1.5 and the final value is 3. Now the initial and final position. So corresponding to t is equal to 0 second, the theta 1 is equal to 0. That means the value of this angle at t is equal to 0 is 0. That means this link will be placed horizontally. And the final position for this cubic is pi by 2. So in this cubic, if you put t is equal to 1.5, then you should get value of theta is equal to pi by 2. And for this cubic, if you put t is equal to 1.5, then you will get the initial position for this cubic, and the initial position of this cubic is equal to theta 1 n. That means this value will be considered as the initial position for this cubic. And the theta 2 n, that means final position for this cubic, is 0 degree. That means the link will start moving from theta is equal to 0, and it will reach to theta is equal to pi by 2. And for this motion, we will use this particular cubic, and then again this link will return back from this position to this position, and this link will follow this cubic to complete this backward motion. Let's substitute all these initial and final conditions and the condition of wire point in these cubic equations, and finally you can calculate the values of all the coefficients. So in the MATLAB, you can implement this substitution of initial and final positions in these equations as follows. So just use the command subs and write the equation. So equation is theta 1. This is the equation theta 1. And in this equation, put t is equal to t1 0. So this is the way how you use the command subs for substituting the value t is equal to t1 0 in the equation theta 1. So if you substitute t is equal to t1 0 in the expression of theta 1, then you should get theta 1 0. That means in the left hand side, you will get 0. Okay. So 0 is equal to, substitute theta 1, t is equal to t1 0 minus theta 1 0 is equal to 0. Similarly, if in the expression of theta 1, in this expression, if you put t is equal to t1 n, t is equal to t1 n, then what you will get? You will get theta 1 is equal to theta 1 n. Okay. So, if you bring this theta 1 n this side, then here you will get 0. So, 0 is equal to this thing minus theta 1 n. Similarly, you will get all the equations. So, corresponding to these initial and final conditions, you will get 8 equations. So these eight simultaneous equations can be written in this particular form. Ax is equal to b, where x is the parameters of cubic, all these parameters, and a are the coefficients of these parameters a10, a11, a12, and so on to a23, and b is the constant coefficients of this equation. So how we will make the matrix A? You know that x will be a vector, but how to form the matrix A? For that you can use the command Jacobian. So in the MATLAB, just search this Jacobian command in help and you will get all the details that how you use the command Jacobian. So in this way you have to fill all the rows of the matrix A. So after executing these 8 operations, you will get the matrix A. Now how to find the vector B? For finding the vector B, you can substitute these parameters equal to 0 in the equation 1 and you will get the first value of B. And here we are using the sign negative because instead of writing equation AX minus B is equal to 0, you can write it as AX is equal to B. So just by using minus sign, you can move B from left to the right side. Similarly, you can substitute the values of these parameters equal to 0 in these equations and you can find out the values of B. So once you found the matrix A, matrix B, then you can find out the vector X as follows. So solve X by using this formula, X is equal to inverse A into B. So inverse A can also be used in this expression by the command A. This type of slash. So it will give you the vector x. So we have found the values of all these parameters a10, a11, a12, a13, and all the remaining parameters of these two cubics. So we have obtained the numerical values, but time is still, we have not generated the value of time. So first of all, we need to generate a series of time. So generate a time series using some time step. So here I have used a time step 0.005 and we know the initial time is 0 for the first qubit, final time is 1.5 for the first qubit, and these are the final and initial time for the second qubit. So using all these informations, we can generate a series of time. So if you know that you have to use this time step, then how many numbers of time between this initial and final value will be generated? So the total number of time stamps will be equal to, suppose n1 is equal to t1n, that is 1.5 minus 0 divided by 0.005 is equal to some value you will get. And this value will indicate that between 0 and 1.5, we will generate this many number of point of time. We will generate this much time instance where we will calculate the value of theta. Okay. So finally, you will generate this n1 number of time instance using this formula. Using this information of n1, you can generate a series of time 1, and this will be a series of time starting from t10. And ending at t1n, this time will increase from this value to this value with an increment of 0.005. Similarly, you can generate this much number of time instance where you can find out the value of theta for this particular qubit. And you can merge this time 1 and time 2 to get the whole time from 0 to 1.5 and 1.523 seconds. Okay, so t will be equal to 0 to 3 seconds. So now we know time 1, time 2. So put t is equal to time 1 and here t is equal to time 2. You will get this type of expression. So once we substituted t is equal to time 1, I have named this theta t as theta a, and it is equal to a10 plus a11 time 1 plus a12. This is this, and you can write theta a dot is equal to just take derivative and you will get a11 plus 2 a12 time 1. Okay, and theta a b dot will take this form. So after this substitution, you will get a numerical value of theta a that will be of size n1. Okay, and the size of theta a dot will be same as theta a, and similarly size of theta a b dot will be of size same as theta a. Similarly, this cubic equation can be written like this: theta b is equal to a20 plus a21 plus a22 plus a23 multiplied by time 2, time 2 square, time 2 cube respectively. Similarly, you can write the expression of theta b dot and theta b b dots. Now generate the reference trajectory, and I have assigned a new name to it as theta ref. So theta ref is equal to theta a and theta b, and theta dot reference is including the theta a dot and theta b dot. Similarly, theta a d dot reference includes theta a d dot and theta b d dot. So in this way, we have generated the reference trajectory for our control system. These are the reference trajectory. Okay. Now let's revisit the assignment. So this is the assignment, and this is the first problem. And in this problem, you need to generate the trajectory. So right now we have generated this trajectory by a name theta, this trajectory by the name theta dot, and this trajectory information by a variable named theta d dot. Okay, so we have generated these reference trajectory, and now we have to find the expression of torque. So once you found the expression of torque, you will get this particular signal. And once you got this particular signal, then apply that signal on the system and you will simulate the response. Okay. So now let's generate the expression of torque. So here is the procedure of derivation of torque. So here we have the diagram of trajectory following control. And if you want to derive the expression of this torque, then you will get this type of equation. Okay. So here F is denoted by a new variable T1. T1 means torque applied on the system. Okay. So torque will be equal to this dij represents generalized mass. Okay. So what this dij means, to understand it, you need to watch the YouTube video with the title generalized Lagrangian formulation. Okay. So watch that video, that is generalized Lagrangian formulation, and in this video you will find the meaning of this dij. So basically this dij represents the generalized mass. Okay. So we know that in trajectory following control, this alpha represents the mass of the system. So this alpha will be dij. Okay. And since we are neglecting the damping and stiffness, so the value of beta will be equal to zero. So finally, what we will get? We will get torque is equal to this alpha, that is dij, into theta 1 d dot reference. Okay, so this is theta 1 d dot reference, this thing minus kp into this error, okay, which is theta 1 minus theta 1 reference. Okay, this is theta 1 and this is theta 1 reference. Okay, and then minus kv into theta 1 dot reference minus theta 1 dot. In addition to this term of mass, we can add the term of gravity, which is di. So di represents the gravity term, and the centrifugal component can be neglected, and we have neglected this centrifugal term. So from the generalized Lagrangian formulation concept,
we can derive this dij is equal to I1, which is moment of inertia of the link, plus ml square by 4. So this will define the generalized mass of the single link. And here centrifugal term is neglected, and the gravity term di is equal to m1 g l1 cos theta.
Next, we need to write the expression of theta 1 d dot reference, expression of theta 1 reference, expression of theta 1 dot reference. So their expressions are written over here. So in the previous slide, we had generated the reference trajectory theta rip, theta dot rip, and theta d dot rip. But here we are defining a new trajectory like theta 1 rip, theta 1 dot rip, theta 1 d dot rip. Why? So let's say that the size of these theta rip, theta dot rip, and theta d dot rip are suppose 500. Okay, that means you have generated 500 values of these theta rip, theta dot rip, and theta d dot rip. Okay, but now in the controller you are using different sampling time. Okay, that means you will get different size of t. So based on the controller sampling time, you can generate a new size of the reference trajectory using the command interp1. Okay, so if you use the command interp1, then this command will generate a new trajectory of different size depending on the size of t. So suppose the size of t is 1000, then you will get a new theta 1 reference of size 1000. Often in controller we need very small sampling time in order to get the more accuracy in the integration. So now we have the expression of torque which is acting on the system. So if we know the equation of motion of this system, then just we can apply this torque on the equation of motion of system and we will get the response. We can simulate the response of the system. So let's derive the equation of motion. Equation of motion can be written as theta 1 d dot is equal to dij inverse of dij into t1 minus dijk minus di. So basically this equation is generated from Newton's second law. That means net force acting on the single link manipulator is a torque t1 minus centrifugal force and the Coriolis force, which is dijk, and this dijk is zero, so we can neglect it, minus the gravity force di. Okay, so this is the net force acting on the single link manipulator, and this will be equal to the generalized mass dij into theta 1 d dot. So ti minus di is equal to theta 1 d dot into generalized mass dij. That means force is equal to mass into acceleration. So if you want to find out acceleration, then acceleration will be equal to mass inverse into net force. Now I have defined this acceleration by a new variable x dot, and if you integrate this x dot, you will get the velocity, and further if you integrate, then you will get the position. So for integrating it, we need values of mass, inertia, moment of inertia, gravity, kp, and kv. Okay, and you can use this command ode4 to integrate this x dot expression. Okay, but for this command ode4, we need a function. So this whole thing you can write in a function one link tfc. You can write in a function one link tfc. Okay, so just write a function x dot is this variable, x dot is equal to one link tfc, and provide all the variables to this function. The variables are these reference trajectory information and the initial condition x, and t, which is the time with respect to which this integration will be done. So this initial condition x is initial position and initial velocity, which you can obtain from this equation, in which we are taking the first value of theta ref, and this theta 1 dot is calculated as the first value of theta d dot reference. So these will be initial conditions for this function. Okay, just define a new variable x naught for initial condition, and this x naught can be substituted here. So this x is equal to OD4 of the, so OD4 we integrate the function one link TFC. So TFC means trajectory following control, and this integration will be done with respect to time, and the initial condition for this function will be x naught, and these are some variables that are required in the function one link TFC. So after this equation, you will get the velocity x dot. Okay, x dot. That means angular velocity you will obtain. You can further integrate it for getting the position of the single link manipulator. So if you run this code in MATLAB, then you will get this type of response. I have used a code of animation just for better visualization, but you can skip this figure of animation and just analyze your response based on 2D figures like this. So using the first cubic, this link has traveled from zero angle to approximately 90 degree angle, and which is equal to 1.57 something, which is pi by 2 radian, and then from 90 degree angle it has returned back to the 0 degree angle. And corresponding to this cubical trajectory, if you take derivative, then you will get this type of velocity profile. So in this way, by using the trajectory following control, we have made our single link manipulator to follow the prescribed trajectory. Now consider a situation. Suppose the m1, i1 and the gravitational acceleration g represents the actual value of mass, moment of inertia and gravity of the single link manipulator. Okay, that means actual mass of the single link is 1 unit, and 1 unit, and moment of inertia is 0.5, and the actual value of gravity is 10. But in the controller you will put the estimated value. So suppose in the controller you used the estimated value of mass m1 and inertia i1, and you estimated the mass m1 wrongly, and the deviation between actual and the estimated value is 0.5 unit. That means in estimation you have used 1.5 unit as the mass, and 0.5 more as the actual moment of inertia. So if you deviate this much from the actual parameters of the system, so if you deviate the estimated values of system parameters inside the controller, then what will be the response? To better observe the response, I am removing the control action. I am removing the trajectory following control, and I am just putting kp is equal to 0. So if you put kp is equal to 0, then kd will also be 0. That means it will become an open loop trajectory following control, and now see how the system behaves. Now increase the value of kp, and if I increase the value of kp to 10, so initially it was 0 and now I have increased the value of kp to 10, and now let's see how the system is behaving now.
The system behavior is somewhat same as we expect, but still there is a significant error in the position and velocity. You see the deviation. Now increase the KP value little more. And now I will make this KP value to 200. Okay. Now see. Now the error value has significantly reduced. Okay, the actual trajectory of single link manipulator is following the reference trajectory with a minimum deviation. So in this way, trajectory following control helps us to make the manipulator to follow a prescribed trajectory. Thank you so much. Now I hope you can solve this assignment and you can easily control your manipulator or the board. Thank you.